Question number 86, which is not true for the given complex. Where this complex is given? This is the complex of cobalt. And what are the statements which are given here? That it is an octahedral complex. Then it exhibits geometrical isomerism. It exhibits optical isomerism. Or it exhibits ionization isomerism. So in this particular question, they are talking about this complex of cobalt. It is here. And this is the compound which has octahedral structure, and its structure can be drawn in this way. I'm just drawing here. So if it is octahedral complex, it should be like this, and bidentate ligand is there, ethane 1,2 diamine, and this is the trans form of this complex compound. So it can also be shown in this manner. Now we can also draw its cis form in the similar manner. In this way, this is the cis form of this compound. Now we have drawn both the cis and trans isomer of this. It means it is octahedral complex, that's true, and it exhibits geometrical isomerism, that is also true. While if we look at the cis form of this complex, you will identify that it has asymmetry in its structure, and that's why it will also exhibit optical isomerism. Now we are left with the fourth option. It exhibits ionization isomerism. If you look at the compound once again, you will identify that in this case, ionization isomerism is not possible, because chloride is the ligand which is present inside this coordination sphere, while outside that sphere, there is again chloride. So in this case, ionization isomerism is not possible. That is why the only statement which is incorrect regarding this complex is it exhibits ionization isomerism. That's why it's wrong. And if it is so, we can easily write that option 4 is the correct option, and that's our correct answer also. After this, let's take next question. Question number 87. Which of the following complexes is not correctly matched with hybridization of its central metal? If we talk about the first option, there is COF6 3 negative D2SP3 hybridization is there. We know that this fluoride is weak field ligand. That's why inner d orbitals are not available for hybridization. It means this hybridization which is given here, D2SP3, is incorrect. Its hybridization should actually be SP3D2. This is wrong. Further, if we talk about SP3 hybridization for nickel carbonyl, tetracarbonyl nickel it is, in this case SP3 hybridization is there, because in this case inner d orbitals are not vacant. That's why this is the correct hybridization for this. Similarly, if I talk about the next compound, that is hexa-aqua chromium ion. In this case, D2SP3 hybridization is there. That's correctly given. Further, in this case, the hybridization is DSP2. Inner orbital are involved in hybridization because ammonia is comparatively stronger ligand. And that's why only one option is not correctly matched here. That is option 1. After that, question number 88. Phosphine can be prepared by the reaction of the simple question from the preparation of phosphine. And we should know that you can prepare phosphine by the reaction of white phosphorus P4 with NaOH. And that results in the formation of PH3. And that's why option 2 is the correct option for this particular question. Question number 89. Which of the following is a pair of peroxy compounds? We have different oxy acids of sulfur. And we know that in this case, we have to look at the structures of these. Let's check what are the structures of these compounds. Now, just have a look on the structures of these compounds. First is H2SO5 in the first option. The structure is given here. This is H2SO5. In this case, you can clearly observe the peroxy linkage. This is peroxy compound, that's fine. Further, if we talk about the next compound, that is H2S2O8. In this compound, you will see that there is the peroxide linkage. I'll just mark it. This is peroxide linkage. And here it is H2S2O8. This is the compound. Now,
In the first option, these two compounds are given, a pair is given, that is peroxy compound, and we can choose it as the correct one. But let's check the next structures also. Here we have H2S4O6. In this case, you will not observe the peroxy linkage, and in case of H2S4O6, no such linkage is there. That's why it is not peroxy compound. After that, there's another one, H2S2O8. That structure we already observed. This was H2H2O8. After that, H2SO5, that we previously seen here, peroxy linkage is there. But in case of H2S2O3, H2S2O3 is given here. I'm just writing here this H2S2O3. In this case also, there is no peroxide linkage. That's why it is also not the peroxy compound. Next is H2SO5, H2S2O3, no peroxy linkage. H2S4O6 and H2S2O3, no peroxy linkage. Only in option 1, both the compounds have the peroxy linkage. That's why these are the peroxy compounds. Answer is option 1. After this, last question of this session. Match items of column 1 with items of column 2. Identify the correct option. We have column 1 of the different processes and column 2. These are the application of these processes. Let's check. Let's match them. Van Urkel process. The Van Urkel process is used for the purification of titanium. That's why you can match this with the third one. After this, cyanide process. Just recall, cyanide process is generally used for extraction of gold. In the leaching process, we use sodium cyanide, and that is also known as cyanide process. So I'll match it with the first one. After that, zone refining. Zone refining is well known process for the purification of germanium. By that method, we obtain ultra pure germanium. So this can be matched with fourth one. Next, Bessemer's process. If we talk about Bessemer's process, that is used for the manufacture of steel. So it can be matched with the second one. Now I have matched all the processes. Now let's choose the correct option. The correct option is here in option 3. That's why the answer for this last question of this paper is also option 3. I hope all the questions, those we discussed today, are clear to you. Thank you so much.